Hi students of class 3. Today we will do one computer class of chapter 3. One class already we have done on the topic chapter 3, introduction to MS Word 2013. On that day I have explained you what is word processor, what is the advantages of word processor, how to start the word processor, and the word processing window, Windows 13 window, the different components of that I have shown it to you. So today we will start with the topic. All the components I will explain to you, what are the different features of each components of word 13, that I will explain it to you. So everyone get ready with the book, page number 34. We will start explaining the chapter. So get ready with a pencil and page number 34 of computer book. Let's start the class. Now this is the component that I have already explained to you. Today I will explain each and every component. Now first starting with the title bar. Title bar is placed at the top of the window. The topmost line is called the title bar. It consists of the name of the document along with the program name. We have here document name and program name. In the left hand side we have the quick access toolbar, and in the right hand side we have some more buttons like the close button, the minimize button, the maximize button, the ribbon display option button. These buttons we have on the right hand side. Okay, now what are the different uses of these buttons? First, the close button is used to close the window. The maximize button is used to reduce the size of the window. The same button is pressed again to bring the window back to the original size. Now, minimize button is used to reduce the window to a small icon on the taskbar. And this ribbon display option button is used to show the ribbon or to hide the ribbon it is used. Okay. Next, we are having the quick access toolbar on the left hand side. Over there, we have the save button, undo button, and the repeat button. Okay. The shortcut keys are over here. Next, we have the ribbon. Now, this ribbon lies just below the title bar. Just below the title bar, you have the ribbon. And this ribbon consisted of different tabs. You can see file tab, home tab, insert tab, design tab. Different tabs are there. And each tab is divided into different groups. The group names are also mentioned. Like the home tab is divided into clipboard, font, paragraph, etc. And these groups, each group has a small buttons at the end. That is called the dialog box launcher. What is this dialog box launcher? This small arrow icon at the bottom, right bottom of some groups is called the dialog box launcher, and it is used to display the additional command related to that group. Okay. In a new window, whenever you click this, a new window will open, and over there you can see some more commands related to this particular group. Now this white area is called the document window. Over here, I told you last day also, over here the cursor is blinking on some place from where we can start our typing. Now we will talk about this file tab. This file tab is at the top left corner of the window, and whenever you click on it, it gets back to the backstage view with the option for opening a new document, opening an existing document, saving a document, printing a document, previewing a document. These all things are inside the file tab. Now we will talk about this scroll bar, the vertical scroll bar and the horizontal scroll bar. This is the vertical scroll bar and this is the horizontal scroll bar. Two scroll bars there we know. The vertical scroll bar is used to move the page up and down, and the horizontal scroll bar is used to move the page left to right. Okay. Rulers. Again, two rulers we have, horizontal ruler and vertical ruler. Horizontal ruler is used to set the left and right margin, and vertical ruler is used to set the top and the bottom margin. Now we will talk about this status bar. This status bar, it is found at the bottom of the window. It shows the current page number and the number of pages on the left hand side it is shown, and on the right hand side it has the view button and the zoom slider. So in the status bar we can see the page numbers on the left hand side, we can see the view buttons on the right hand side along with the zoom slider over here. Okay, we have a flash test over here. This is called the repeat button. This one is called the save button. Next, this one is called the ribbon display option button, and this one is the undo button. Now one quick bite is here. If we cannot see the ruler, we can click on the view tab and put a tick in the ruler box, and the ruler will be implemented in the document area. Okay, so till here we will end the class. So what are the things we have done today? We have explained all the components of the Windows 13, what 2013 window, all the components I have explained it to you. So today's HW work will be to read page number 34, 35 and 36 till the flash test over here, and after finishing it please go through the previous part of the chapter that we have done in the last class. So stay at home, do your work, and if you have any query regarding today's class please write in the comment box. I will reply you back. Bye bye.